Right. Right. I'm going to recreate what the cleethorpes to Skegness route would have been like back in the days when all the minor lines were here, if you like. I don't know if that's what. So if I just, let's just explain. Okay. Yesterday we went to Skegness in Lincolnshire on the train. The train they used was the class 153, which is the train I am going to use on this scenario, this quick drive, in the East Midlands livery, lovely orangey blue colour, and it travelled from Cleethorpes to Skegness. So the route it took was Cleethorpes all the way to Lincoln, then you have to change trains, and then you would go from Lincoln to Sleaford, but Sleaford's not on here, so I'm presuming that's South Lincolnshire, which it is. Maybe that was the boundaries in them days. And then from Sleaford to Skegness. So, the total journey time was round about, I don't know, a couple hours, if you don't include all the waiting times you have to have. But that journey yesterday included hours wait at Lincoln, approximately 15 minute wait at Sleaford. Left Cleethorpes at 15 minute wait at Grimsby as well. So the train left Cleethorpes at 08:56 and arrived in Skegness at 12:58. So we're going to recreate what I think would have been the route in the day. Now, you have two options. We can go from Grimsby to Lincoln. And then from Lincoln to Skegness. Or we can go from Lincoln, not Lincoln, Cleethorpes, sorry. So we can go from Cleethorpes to Lincoln and then Lincoln straight to Skegness, or we could go Cleethorpes straight to Boston and then from Boston to Skegness. Now the train does go through Boston in the modern day, but it goes from anyway, so I've decided we're going to do what I think would have happened. So we're going to miss out all the waiting times. So let's put the master key in. There we go. And we'll have some instrument lights on as well. Okay, well, instrument lights, is that that one? I can't think which one it is. That's the one. Okay. Okay. We'll do that. Love it like that. Okay. Right, let's get some passengers on the board. So let's do the first stint will be Cleethorpes to Lincoln. We're going to leave at 12 minutes past rather than 08:56 because we're not going to include any weights. So we're going to leave at 12 minutes past 9. So when we get into Grimsby at 20 past, roughly 20 past 9. Okay. Let's set this train up. Okay, would you out of station in about 20 seconds? So. We're ready to go. Yes, let's put some lights on because that's what we need. Okay. Okay, let's go. So let's get going. Let's see how this pans out. Cleethorpes to Lincoln Central. Let's reduce that. This should take us to the first notch takes us to 15.2 miles an hour exactly, so that's good. Suggetts Lane, LC crossing. That's the one they're trying to close, isn't it? Or they are closing, I think. Okay, let's just check these signals. Okay, everything looks good. I don't know what. We're going to call at all the stations. What this was would call at. Let's go back up, let's get up to speed. Okay. I'll break the speed limit. Right, our first station that it does actually call at is New Clee. So let's go to New Clee. Right, so here we are at New Clee. Let some people on board. Next station that it called at was Grimsby Docks. So we shall call at Grimsby Docks. We have a 25 mph call at Grimsby Docks. Ryby Street Station, unused. We're going to be late into Grimsby. Maybe we should have gone a bit earlier. Okay, right. So here we are at Grimsby Docks. While that's doing that, I'm going to check that line because sometimes it throws you off. Let's go have a look. Where is it? Here we are at Grimsby Dock, so I need to be looking for. Ah, right, it's taking me there. Okay, right, we'll alter this one. It wouldn't normally come into Grimsby Town 3. But actually, it would go into Grimsby Town 3. Slightly late, but we're going to Grimsby Town 3. Now, after Grimsby Town Station, the only two stations it calls at on the next length of the journey would be Heybrook and Barnetby. Might just slow down in time for the speed limit. Maybe. Let's see. I think we will. Yes, I think we will. Without having to brake. Perfect. But we will have to slow down in a minute because we've got a 15 mile an hour limit going to station. Even though it doesn't show it. So we get that train slowed down to 15 miles an hour. Here we are at Grimsby Town 3. Which is actually the state, it's actually the platform it does leave from actually. Do that. probably won't be able to find it. No, probably not. We'll have a look at that another time. Okay, let's go. Should have slowed down a bit earlier, never mind. I was speeding slightly, but it wouldn't normally go around this siding. It wouldn't normally be travelling on the right hand side of the track either, that's why it comes over here. So we don't call here. Not calling it here. Next one we're calling it is Hebrew. So we're just about to pass through Healing and then Stalinborough. And our next stop is now approaching. It will be Haber. And we will slow down to 20 miles an hour. Because there's a to enter the station. Perfect. So we'll just roll into the station 20 miles an hour. So here we are. At Haber, just about to roll and supply some brakes. We don't want to overshoot. Paper. Let's have a quick look at the train while we're here. It's only one coach. And let's see what it says on it. Cleethorpes. Oh, okay. Can we change the destination on this train? No. Well, we probably can, but I'm not sure how you do it. Let's look at the manual for that. But you can change the destination, so there you can. It is coming from Cleethorpes. But the thing is, it's not. It's going to Lincoln. Next stop should be Barnaby. Let's take a quick look in the coaches. Oh, no, that's the wrong camera. There we are. Yeah. They're actually, these seats on these trains are the wrong colour. They're actually orange, they're actually a red colour. That's okay. but everything else looks the same. The windows. This is a disused station now. We do still pass through it though, even in the modern day. Barnaby station coming up, 1¾ miles. we need to slow down to 40 miles an hour before we enter the station. See if we can slow down without braking. Possibility. Might have to break. In fact, we will have to break. Let's slow down. Barnaby. The only station stop that we have to do now between here and Lincoln, according to the timetable, is Market Raisin. So let's see all the stations that we might be passing through. Oh, it's quick. Wait for the guard to buzz. Okay, I'm okay to go. But to Lincoln still. We have to keep to 30 miles an hour. In a minute. No point in going any faster. Release the throttle. that line there. Should be taking a left, I think. Yeah. So the next station stop's going to be Market Raisin. What station is this? It is. Howsham. We're not stopping there. So Howsham, we've got North Kelsey. Next station is Moortown. Oh, that bump was a bit big, wasn't it? passing through Holton Le Mar. Bridges look fairly accurate. Let's remember these bridges. Totally marked. And then we're going to passing through Claxby. Well, hang on. Claxby and what does that say? Usselby. Still 19 miles away. I think Market Razor must be coming up pretty soon. We haven't passed through it yet. All those stations that we've just been through don't exist. anymore. They obviously did do back then. Here's our next stop. Just seen it. Market raisin. Finally, we've found a raisin. Let's coast into Market Raisin. Should be in for about 10:05. This is actually a scheduled stop, this one. So let's have a look at the station. It pretty much looks like that. Yes, it does actually. I remember these walls looking like that. I don't know where that wall's gone. So what's on this side then? Yeah, it pretty much looks like that. In real life. Yeah. Cool. Okay, the last stop will be Lincoln. Just wait for the guard. Miles an hour. There's no speed set on this thing. I thought there might have been a speed set button. Bridge. Oh, there's another station coming up, which we won't be stopping at, and it is Wickenby. All these stations are disused. Snelland. Well, the scenery looks pretty much the same. Another station coming up. Yeah, we do pass. I think Langworth still exists. Oh, it does. And I remember passing Langworth. It probably doesn't exist, but there's a crossing near it. I think that's still there. So let's see what happens when we get to Langworth. we can recognise from here. It's probably Langworth Crossing there. I do remember some buildings on the left. Yeah, there is a crossing at Langworth. It's just here, I think. Yeah, that does look, that bit is accurate. That was accurate. Siding going down there to Reapham. So this station doesn't exist either. Probably all the crossings still exist though. So we're coming into Lincoln soon. 4.5 miles. long to go now. A couple of miles. Right, we're going to start coasting for 20 mile an hour. Just see Lincoln in the distance there. Might be able to slow down to 20. Signals on caution. What is it? We'll break at the last minute. I think there's a little crossing to whistle for. Any minute. There's Lincoln. Definitely need to break now, we're not going to make it. We've got a bit of a hill there as well. We can coast down up to 20 now. So here we are at Lincoln. It looks pretty much the same. Another level crossing there, I think. It's holding us nicely at 18 mile an hour. I'm coming in this way, are we? This is the first part of it done. So that's the first part done. We have to load up another route now once this is completed. Thank you. Let's go back and get to the other route. Where we have to Lincoln to this is Skegness. Let's say 10. Alright, let's load up this second scenario and we'll see what stations we go through. If it's any different to say in the real life, in the modern day one, we would now be going from Lincoln to Sleaford, but Sleaford's not on this route. Although you do go through Boston. But what I'm going to do is do it direct from Lincoln Skeggy and see if we do go through Boston. It's a possibility. Do when it loads up. Okay, we're not on the same platform, but fair enough. Let's put the master key in. Let's put the lights on. Let's put the instrument lights on. Where are they? Where are they? Where are they? Lights. Okay. That one. Right, let's put it into. That's what I've done. Well, we may go. I know we'll get some passengers. Okay, so now we're going from Lincoln to Skegness, and we'll also see which stations we go through. Right, let's accelerate up to the 20 miles an hour limit. It actually holds at about 18 miles an hour. Just make sure I've got a clear signal. Yep. Another 44 miles. Okay, we've been approved. Accelerating up to 40 in a minute. Wait for that. So she will accelerate up to 40 miles an hour. Which I think 82, this notch will give us 40 miles an hour approximately, I think. Does. Alright, don't know how long we're going to be sat at 40 miles an hour for, but that's the speed limit, so let's do it. river looks familiar. So far we go around this bend. I do remember these rivers, or one of them anyway. So that's our next stop. No, we didn't stop there, Washingborough. No, we didn't stop there. So let's carry on. No, we definitely didn't stop at Washingborough. This bend's not too bad. I was easy enough for this one. So every so often you hear that buzzing noise, that beeping noise. That's because if you don't touch any of the controls for so long, we get that warning sound comes up and you have to respond to it by pressing Q. So, and if you don't respond to it, it slams the brakes on. Stops your train. So basically it's just telling you, making sure there's still a driver present not all trains, locos, do it, but with the 153 does, because I bought this one, this loco from Just Trains, and it's the advanced pack, so that's why you get all everything that you would get in real life on this particular train. You can actually operate on the game. Right, so the next station is 5 Mile House. No, that one definitely didn't stop there. Could be in for a bit of a long drive at this speed. 40 miles an hour. That means we could be, according to that, 40 miles an hour. 40 miles to go, should be an hour. Out, but then again it's not going to be 40 miles an hour all the way there. So this is the 5 Mile House, another station that doesn't exist now, but did back then. Oh, got to 20 miles an hour now. Oh. Okay, fair enough. We'll start slowing down for that. Little bit too early. I think I could probably afford to have braked a bit later than that. Oh, yeah. Why we're slowing down to 20. I know we do slow down a few times along this way. Let's just put two notches of power, and that'll hold us at about 18 miles an hour. Because if you do it on the third notch, it takes us too high. I think it's because of this bend. get around here, we'll be able to speed back up again. Just wait till it gets past the 40 mile an hour board. Off we go. I mean, it took us, what, 9:20? About 3.5 hours. To get there. It's going to take us approximately 2 hours 40 minutes. That sounds about right. No signals on here. I'm coming up. Might be a station coming up. There is a station coming up. Let's see what it says. Bardney. Well, no, we definitely didn't go for that. Oh, Bardney to Boston. Alright, maybe we did go through there, we just didn't see it. I don't think Bardney Station exists. Check, see if it does it. So this is Bardney. Are you fished here before? Bardney on the River Witham. Doesn't exist. We probably drove through it and didn't realise. I don't remember seeing any disused platforms. Any stations that we actually stopped at, we will stop at. Here's a station. What's this one? Livery. No, we didn't stop at that one either. That's another place on the Wyvern. The River Wyvern. Fished on the river a few times. It's not a bad little river. Bit crap in the summer though. Well, I don't know about now, it was when we went. It's just, couldn't get it. I could bloody catch him with eels all day. Plenty of eels in the Wyvern, well, there used to be, don't know about now. There is another station that doesn't exist anymore. Looks like the River Wyvern on the right hand side. Must have come through Suffrey or Southrey, whatever you want. I call it Suffrey. Just going to follow the River Wyvern. And we've got 32.5 miles still to go. Next station. Stixwold. No, didn't go there either. That obviously doesn't exist, that one. And we're going to have another 20 mile an hour limit coming up. Let's see if we can slow down this time for it. Without having to brake too much. The river's on both sides again. Stixwold. However you pronounce that. Stixwold. I think it's pronounced Stixwold. if you think about it. Because if you think of the word could and change it to a W, it would be would. So I think it sticks would. Anybody else think it's not? Put your comments in below. Well, I don't know. Let's just put that up to 70. And we're going to be going back up to 40 again in a minute. But there's no point because we're going, well, this is. And then back down to 20 again. See, the point of this 20 mile an hour limit, it's not really nothing unless it's a bad bend or something. We'll see. And then go back up to 40 miles an hour. But then half a mile later, we're back down to 20, so there's no point in speeding up too much. Hello. What's this? Oh, it's a temporary speed restriction, that's what it is. That's what the letter T for. The letter T means terminate, I think. So I think that's what it was. It was a temporary speed restriction there. Well, we're no point going any faster than that. To break a little bit here. Must be another temporary speed restriction. Or maybe it's because of that bend there, maybe. Probably. It looks like a bad bend, doesn't it? Probably why you gotta do 20 round that bend. You'd probably come off the tracks if you went too fast. Ah yeah, I can see it. Bends one way then the other. Understandable then? Right, taking a bit longer. Next one. Woodall Junction. No, we definitely didn't go through there. That's definitely the River Witham on the right hand side there. So we'll probably be able to find this track. Woodall Junction. Obviously a level crossing here where the bridge is, road bridge. Track's going to leave the River Witham. The River Witham's going off to the right and we're going towards the left. So we're leaving the River Witham now. And another 20 mile an hour limit coming up. Up to this one then. Now we're going to have a 50 mile an hour limit in a minute. Cool, get there a bit quicker. This is probably joining the Boston line, I think. And we'll just check that signal. Break a little bit. Let's give my passengers a decent ride. Oh, we're back at the River Witham again. Ah, I thought we'd left that. Going to the left by the looks of it. Right then, let's okay, so what goes to the right? Well, we're going left. I think we're going left. Or are we? Yes, we are going left. Thought we would be. Let me just get past this. Get up to a decent speed. We definitely left the River Witham now. See what other stations we're going to come across. Oh, there's a station coming up. And this one is Coningsby. Yep. Been there before as well. Not the station, that probably doesn't exist. I don't think it does. That was a bit of a bump. No, Coningsby doesn't exist. There's a Coningsborough, but that's near Doncaster. Yeah, obviously they existed back in them days, so otherwise it wouldn't be on here. Well, we've still got 25 miles to go. Well, the time's coming down now. I think that was the Bane, River Bane that we just went over. I know the River Bane is a tributary of the Wyvern, and I know the River Bane runs near Coningsby. Another station coming up. Wonder what this one's going to be. Tumby Wood. Tumby Woodside. Let's have a look, see if that one still exists. I don't think it does. No. No, it doesn't exist. Probably, obviously all these stations did exist back in the days when the steam trains were about, but when these lines are... So, it would have probably been quicker getting to Skegness if the route still existed. this particular route wouldn't have to go all the way around by Sleaford and Boston. Signals coming up. So this is Tumby Woodside. Still 22 miles to go yet. Good, we took the power off on it. Well, we are going downhill. That's okay. Slight bit of a hill there. If I hadn't took the power off, I would have gone straight over the speed limit. Right, where's the next one then? New Bolingbroke. Well, all I know about New Bolingbroke is they've got a castle there. A Bolingbroke castle. Well, I say there's a castle there. It's about 2 or 3 stones high, what's left of it. But you can actually see the outline of it. Look up on Google Earth for Bolingbroke and you'll probably find it, or on Google Maps. Oh, it does exist. Bolingbroke Castle. But like I say, I've been there, I've seen it, and there's very little of it left. It's probably just a couple of layers of stones high. But it basically goes like what's left of it is like the outer walls of it, so you can see how big it was. But yeah, that's New Bolingbroke. It's only a small station or whatever it was. Not very big. Bit of a hill coming up in a minute. Miles to go. Another station coming up. I'm not sure what this one's going to be. Oh, yes. Stickney. Oh, that. Well, the station does not exist anymore, but I've actually seen Stickney on the map. Stickney, not far from Skeg. Well, Mike, you never know if you visit some of these places, you might be able to find evidence at the stations. Sometimes you get a building. I've been to some of these places where you'll see a house and you'll think, oh, it's just a house. But it's not, it's actually an old station building. And then people buy them. And then convert them into somewhere to live in. But yeah, there's one or two places like that. So here's Stickney. We didn't even go anywhere near Boston by the looks of it. So if we was travelling to Skegness back in the day, we would have got there a lot quicker than what you would have done if you was doing it in the modern day. Definitely. Another station coming up. Midville. No, I've not visited that place before. Midville. Here we go. Found it. It's Midville, Boston in the UK. So that's what Midville looks like. And this just so happens to be a road called Station Road. So where will the station be then? So if this is Station Road. Not not sure about that one. This road coming off here. You got Midville Road, the Hobhole Drain, and then you got Station Road. So obviously the Station Road is a giveaway, isn't it? I wonder where the station was then. So they've got Station Road. Well, the station couldn't be far away then. And what's this little place here? Fosdyke Bank. I'm not sure about that one. Can't see any evidence of a station or a train track that might have been there. Although they does say Station Road, so that does give it a bit of a clue. We're going up to 65 miles an hour in a minute. Midville, Stickney, I think Eastville's going to be coming up as well. The only station that I think we'll pass through that actually exists today is Wainfleet. We're now going to pick up some more speed. So I think we're going to be going through Eastville and Friskney. Oh no, we're not. Little Steeping. Okay. We're Steeping. Wainfleet All Saints, Wainfleet St. Mary. Oop. Steeping then. Little Steeping. Station Road there, look. Eastville Station Road. We're just coming to slowing down to 25 mile an hour in a minute. Fat World Coast. Ten and a half miles to go. Otherwise we're not going to make that speed limit. Another river. Probably the Steeping. I've heard of that river. And we're not far now. We're going to be turning off. By the looks of it. Yep. Going to the right. Speed on this junction, then we can get back up to 50 miles an hour again. Oh, fuck off with speeding or whatever. It was actually. I thought we'd already gone up to 50. Never mind. I just want to get there now. Culvert. No. be in Skegness in approximately 17 minutes, 18 minutes. Got 30 mph limit coming up. Okay. Let's coast for that one then. What station's this one coming up? It is Wainfleet. Well, we did actually stop at this station. So we will do that. We will stop at Wainfleet. Maybe we should have gone the other way. I don't think they would have come this way. I don't know, they might have done. I think they probably would have gone to Boston. Lincoln, then Boston. In fact, no, they wouldn't. They would have gone from Cleethorpes straight to Boston via Louth. Alford, that way. Yeah, so it was back in the in them days. They would have gone from Grimsby through to Louth, then to Alford, then to Boston. They'd have gone that way. They wouldn't have even touched Lincoln in them days. But I suppose we could try it again another... I might try it again another time. And then I'll go Lincoln to Boston, then Boston to Skeg. And see how that goes. Yeah, so we're coming into Wainfleet. We did actually stop at Wainfleet. So there's a 30 mph limit coming into Wainfleet, which we are now coasting down to. Hopefully slow down in time for that. If not, we'll just have to apply a little brakes. Okay. It's looking good. Apply a little bit of brake. Okay, we need to brake now anyway because the station's coming up. And here's Wainfleet. And it looks like a castle or something. So we'll stop here because we do stop here. don't think there's any more stations between here and Skegness now. Shouldn't be. May be wrong. Well, we'll sit at 26 miles an hour. Accelerate in a minute. That was perfect. Right, let's go 50 miles an hour again. There's another station. Avon House. So I might just want to take it a bit easy on this bit. Station coming up. I wonder what this one is. It is Seacroft. Obviously that one doesn't exist anymore. I'm slowing down to 30 miles an hour again in a minute. Two and a half miles away from Skegness. mate. Here's Seacroft. Might slow down in time, actually. Possibility. 0.4 of a mile to go. And we don't have to even use our brakes, just let it coast down to 30 miles an hour. I don't know, we might not do it. Just judged it a little bit wrong. See. The horn. A little bit too much brakes then. 20 miles an hour in a minute. It was a slow approach going into Skegness, I remember this. Skegness platform 8. Platform 8? Oh hello, where to slow down. How am I going into platform 8? Where's the train? There it is. Why is he saying I'm going to Skegness 1 then? That's weird. It says I'm going into stop at Skegness 8. How am I going to get to Skegness 8? That means I'd have to come down here. That's going to take me to Skegness 1. Don't really want to go in Skegness 1. There's probably not that many platforms on it. Shut up. What we'll do is we'll go. This is obviously not what you would do, but in order for the scenario to finish, I've got to do it like this. I shall go to here, and then see if I can reverse back to here. So we'll go past the next junction. The brakes have come on full. Forgot to turn it off. I know it's already stopped anyway. Let's go past this junction here. And then we'll should be able to reverse back. So just stop at Skegness 8, but it's not going to stop at Skegness 1. Let's turn the power off. We should be fine at this. Stop here. Let's just check that. Where are we? Oh yeah. Does it look like it's going to change, does it? Oh, it might be that one there. Anyway, it's this one, isn't it? Go past that one, and it'll bring us onto here, and then we should be able to come into Skegness 1. Skegness 8? That's a weird, isn't it? So, let's go like that. So we need to go past this signal here, and then that should change us over to this line here, and then we should be able to go straight into Skegness 8. So we'll just nip past this signal. Yeah, it's the junction's flipped over now. Let's break. Am I breaking? Here we are. Let's switch sides, switch ends. We've got to come back over onto this line on the left. So that's what we're going to do. Oh, hang on. But, yeah, danger's approved. Good job I did that, actually. Otherwise that would have been game over for us. How far we got to go? It should automatically switch over. Has it not done it? Yes, it has. Okay, let's stop here. Shouldn't have to do this in real life, should we? But that's what the train's gonna do. So now, we're fine to go into Skegness 8 now. Might need to get approval going here. Okay, so let's switch cabs again. Now we can get into Skegness 8. Weird that is. We was routed to go into Skegness 1, but we're not supposed to be stopping there. We're supposed to be going into Skegness 8. So we've had to do a few little manoeuvres on the points. Which is okay, not a problem. And I think there's a signal that needs to be... No. Oh, no. Well, those signals that I just saw earlier... Where's Skegness 8 then? It's probably right around the other side. It's down here. Okay, we'll just coast into it. No, the signals are not for us. They are, couple coming out. When we pass them, they should turn green. Yeah, mate, we are finally at Skegness 8. After manoeuvring the signal, waiting for the signal box to change us over. I think we'll park us close to the thingy bobs. Car there. Right, let's stop the train here. And that's the end of the what is it? In real when we got here, yeah, that's how it looks. You go through the, there's some gates here, and just over here, I don't know about now, but was a bus station here. And that's the station, and that leads you out into Skegness. So that's it, we're here. Anyway, thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed it. And I am going to call it a night. This is now 2:30 in the morning. Thought it's been a bit of a drag, that one. Okay, so take care, everyone.